Hi, this is Julie Harland, and I'm your math gal. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you could search for any of my videos organized by topic. This is part 7 of absolute value inequalities, and on this video, we solve the following two problems. All right, here's our first problem. We have the absolute value of 3 minus 2x is greater than or equal to 5. Right? So different ways people think about it. I like to think about it algebraically, actually. I think that number here, whatever's inside that absolute value, is either going to have to be bigger than the number 5, or it could be less than negative 5. So when I take the absolute value of it, it'll be bigger than 5. Or you remember how to set up the problem when you have greater than or equal, which is this. You take what's in the absolute value, 3 minus 2x, and you change both the direction of the inequality and the opposite of the next number. So I'm going to rewrite that as less than or equal to negative 5. Then you write or, don't forget to put or. You write the whole thing again without changing the inequality at all. And without changing that 5. So you just write 3 minus 2x is greater than or equal to 5. Okay, so those are the two ways I thought about it algebraically as well. Now we have to solve these two. Okay, so how about subtracting 3 from both sides to begin with? So I get negative 2x is less than or equal to, well, negative 5 plus negative 3 is negative 8. And now to solve this inequality, I'm going to have to divide by a negative 2. But remember what happens when you multiply or divide by a negative? It switches the inequality sign, so this is going to change to greater than or equal. So I get x is greater than or equal to, all right, what's a negative 8 divided by negative 2? 4. So that's one possibility. Now let's go over and solve the other inequality. Remember, the steps are the same. I'm going to have to subtract 3 first. So I get negative 2x is greater than or equal to 5 minus 3 is 2. And then we're going to divide by negative 2, because that's the coefficient of x. But when you divide by a negative, that switches to less than or equal. So that gives me x is less than or equal to negative 1. And remember, it's or. So what it's saying is x is either bigger than or equal to 4, or it's less than or equal to negative 1. What would that look like on a graph? Here's 0, there's 4, and negative 4. Okay, so it's going to be less than or equal to negative 1. So it's to the left of negative 1, and or it could be greater than or equal to 4. So it's to the right. So 0 is not one of the answers, right? 1 is not one of the answers. 2 is not. 3, etc. Any number in between negative 1 and 4, right, is not an answer. And you could check that. Do that in your head. If you put in 0 for x, does this make a false statement? It should, otherwise 0 would be a solution. So if you put in 0 for x, you'd get 3 minus 0, which is 0, I mean, which is 3, and the absolute value of 3 is 3. Is 3 greater than 5? No. Okay, so that's why 0 is not a solution. And you could pick a number to the right of 4 or to the left of negative 1, similarly, and check. Okay, so that's something I'm going to leave for you to do. Just do a little trial, to make sure you're in the ballpark here, and it seems reasonable that you've got the right answer. So this is the graph of it, and how would we write this in interval notation? I'm going to make this a little bit smaller so I can get this all on the same screen. Right, so how do we write the answer using interval notation? So it's in between negative inf it goes from negative infinity to negative 1 by looking at the picture, I got that, union 4 to infinity. Now it's okay if you want to write going from 4 to infinity union negative infinity to negative 1. All right, that's okay. But I usually like to just put the smaller numbers on the left and then union the, what's on the right. So if I graphed it, that's why I came up with that. But it's perfectly okay to write going from 4 to infinity, union from negative 1. Whoops, did that wrong. Let's can't write that. From negative infinity to negative 1. So you could write it that way. For instance, if you had just gone directly there, you might have written it that way, but be really careful that you don't put the negative infinity to the right of negative 1, etc. Okay, so I think it's easier to see the solution when you write it like this. It kind of matches what the graph looks like. Right, let's go on to the next problem. Okay. Oops, that's not supposed to be equal. Right, here's our next problem. 4x minus 3 and the absolute value sign plus 1 is greater than 10. Go ahead, try this on your own first. You're going to get some, I think, a fraction for part of your answer. Okay, so we want to isolate the absolute value. So let's subtract 1 from both sides to isolate it. And that gives us absolute value of 4x minus 3 is greater than 9. So we know whatever's in here, right? For its absolute value of that to be bigger than 9, it could either be less than negative 9, right? If you picked a number less than negative 9 to put in the absolute value, certainly, when you simplified it, you get a true statement, or whatever's in there could just be bigger than 9. Okay, and I'm just following the pattern also. So now we need to solve this. So let's add 3 to both sides. And you know when I solve the other part, I'm going to also add 3. So I'm just going to write it down there as well right now. That gives me 4x is less than, all right, what's negative 9 plus 3? That's negative 6. And then I'm going to divide by positive 4. Now when you divide by a positive, you just keep the inequality symbol just like it is. You do not switch it unless you multiply or divide by a negative. So this is negative. All right, what's negative 6/4? That's negative 3/2 or negative 1/2. I'm going to write it in terms of a reduced, as a mixed number. Okay. Hopefully you have no problem reducing that to negative 3/2, and then that could be written as negative 1/2. Let's do the other one now. After we add 3 to both sides, we get 4x is greater than 12. And then we'll divide both sides by 4. Again, when we divide by a positive number, it does not switch the inequality sign, so we get x is greater than 3. So we have either x is greater than, I'm sorry, x is less than negative 1/2 or x is greater than 3. So how could we write that in interval notation? I'm writing big, so again, I'm going to just make this a little bit smaller so we can get it all in. How do I write x is less than negative 1/2 in interval notation? It goes from a negative infinity to negative 1/2. You could leave that as negative 3/2. That's perfectly fine. But it's got a parentheses around it because it's just strictly less than, not less than or equal. Union, right? Instead of writing or, we write union. How do we write x is greater than 3? We write 3 to infinity. And this is our answer written in interval notation. If you want to graph it, here's 0, here's negative 3 and positive 3. All right, so if we want numbers less than negative 1/2, we would have to go right here, negative 1/2, and go this way. And numbers to the right of 3, we would go that way. All right, so that's what the graph looks like. Notice that 0 is not a solution. So if you went back to your original problem and you plugged in 0, it should be false. Okay? Now, where's the original? It's all the way up here. So you would have to plug it into the original. So let's go ahead and just check this one. All right, so here was our solution, and here was the original inequality. And let's just check something. We could either check to make sure 0 is not a solution, because that'll make a false, or we could pick something in the solution and make sure it's true. I'll check to make sure 0 really is not in the solution. So this better come out false. So we have 4 times 0 minus 3 plus 1. Is that going to be greater than 10? So what is this? 4 times 0 is 0, and 0 minus 3 is negative 3. So I've got absolute value of negative 3 plus 1. Is that going to be bigger than 10? Absolute value of negative 3 is 3. Is 3 plus 1 bigger than 10? I think right here you could say no. So it's true that x equals 0 is not a solution. Now if you want, you could plug in a number bigger than 3 and make sure it is a solution. Or pick a number smaller than negative 1 half and make sure it's not a solution. It's impossible to put in every single possible solution, so you're just trying to get an idea if you've pretty much got it close to the answer. To make sure that it's the endpoints here, the 3 and the negative 1 half are true, actually plug in 3 and you should get it exactly the same number on both sides. Or when you put in negative 1 half, you should get exactly the same number on both sides. That's the only way to check for sure. All right, we'll do some tricky problems on the next video. So we'll just continue working a few more problems with absolute value inequalities when we have greater than or equal. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you can view all of my videos, which are organized by topic.